I will try to keep it short as well. I think what Dagmar and Emma just said, the launch of a new step, a next step in the collaboration in the Eurodelta, the importance of that can hardly be overstated. And I would like to point to some challenges that I feel are really very important and ways to approach it, maybe a little bit of a start of an agenda and just to give you some food for thought. Cannot be overstated, obviously. I think we all know our biggest challenge at hand is the climate crisis we have. And of course, we always see this kind of graphs showing basically a completely new way of living and being that needs to be developed in a time span that is so short that we really have to come up with crisis measures more as than transformative measures. And I think last year has showed us that this is possible, but it's also showed us at what cost this comes. And of course, we all know these graphs, but the chilling fact is that 10 years ago, the graph was more or less the same. Eh? So predicting that we would change our way, for instance, in this way, in this graph showing the way we produce our energy, showing a sort of radical change. And this radical change is not coming forward. Eh? We have to be honest about that. And that is a serious problem. Of course, we have this very nice Eurostat statistics always showing particularly how the Eurodelta area, I speak of the Eurodelta area because I'm so ashamed that actually the Netherlands is the one which is really last in line. So just maybe by coming together with Luxembourg, Belgium and Germany, we are in a bit better shape, but actually we're lagging behind so much in this transformation that the reality is not in line with how we feel about such an area. And we have quite a positive idea about the prosperity and the quality of life in this area, but at the same time, this is also the reality. We're lagging behind seriously. And this is not only in terms of reaching our targets, our set goals, but this is a serious business, particularly for the medium long term. And this is a recent report in the Netherlands made to new estimates about the sea level rise and the amount of investments that need to be done in order to keep the Delta safe is gigantic. And with this quite quick change means that we will have to do this over and over and over again, and that it actually doesn't, we have to do it over and over again, and it needs to be done quicker and quicker. So can we sustain our living in this Delta area? This is a serious question. Can we sustain our living for ourselves in this respect? But of course, there's also much wider consequences. This map was also already shown, and this the amount of air pollution, nitrogen in this case, in Europe. Recent images by a new satellite giving very clear the point of where the problems lie. So this has real consequences. Huh? For instance, in biodiversity loss, huh? And of course this is down to pollution, but it's also down to something else, and that is land take. We have in this Delta area a lot of other things happening at the same time, and this is impacting our biodiversity system. For instance, huh? The rapid growth currently very much connected with the harbor of Rotterdam, of the whole logistics and warehousing that's going on in the Delta area. Recent work by one of my colleagues, Merten Neffs, showing basically how in a very short period of time, a lot of land is taken for new kind of functions, which basically are all down to ourselves shopping online, like facilities like these come up in rapid succession in this area. On top of that, we need to build a million new homes, just as that we did 25 years ago. So this is a picture from 25 years ago when we said, well, this is an enormous task to do. We need to do it again. If you map all of the national spatial needs in the Netherlands, for instance, and just as an example, it won't be much different in Belgium or Germany. It is an enormous amount of land uses which are piled on top of each other, on top of this huge, humongous crisis. I think it's very important to state that this is an important task that we need to take at hand, and I would challenge the next generation to come up with ideas to do that. Of course, we've also tried to do our share. Joachim showed something from this work yesterday as well. I think it's interesting also to take this approach. It was also mentioned in a couple of talks before that, that to take the approach of what is the kind of assets, the value assets that are available in this area. It's not nothing. It's the quality of life. That's the other side of the coin. So for instance, we did some mapping on all of the different qualities that are there. And I think it's interesting just to go through this work. It's available for you to use. We looked at very different aspects, and I think it's interesting to note, and I think this is also a very interesting, important agenda of getting ahead in the Eurodelta, is to share our data on how this area actually functions. For instance, this was one of the maps showing the commuting patterns in the Eurodelta, and of course, there's a lot of data missing, but what you also see is that within countries, within certain boundaries, the data is very refined, but from the country to another country, for instance, in this case, Flanders to the Netherlands, you suddenly lose that kind of quality in terms of data, and that's also, I think, a very important agenda to make sure that we can have a data set to build upon. In this particular work, we try to address these value-based assets. It was done for Flanders and the Netherlands only, but I think it can be extended quite easily and should be for the whole Eurodelta. We came up with 7 assets. I won't go through them all, but I think it's interesting. There are interesting takes on certain things that we can bring forward later on. So this is an important aspect, a value-based approach, but you can also think of certain shared agendas that are really important. Of course, shared agendas also lead to all kinds of collaborations, and you need to also be aware that there are many and a lot. There's already a lot of cooperation going on all kinds of different fields. And the question, and I think Dagmar also posed it very clearly, is should we not combine this more, and should it not be more in an overarching strategic agenda for the Eurodelta area? I think the question begs a clear answer, and it should be positive. But just as a tryout, we came up with a couple of agenda points that are really important. I think this was mentioned in the first day by Sabine Stoop. What if you draw the watershed areas for instance, what kind of map does that deliver? It's a different kind of geography. It's a different kind of relations that come up. And I think it's important to understand this kind of logic, because climate change severely impacts the logic of this area in these watershed areas. And it's not only in terms of drought and too much water, but it's also in terms of the water system as a connecting element between the whole region in terms of its different economic centers that are connected. Another agenda, the energy transition agenda. It's very interesting to see the differences there. So for instance, the Netherlands, of course, as we've seen in the graph, is not doing very well in its share of sustainable energy delivery, and the differences are really quite big. For instance, the share of solar power, the Netherlands has only 1/6 of per capita of sustainable energy production by solar power. If you compare it to, for instance, Belgium or North Rhine-Westphalia, or if you look at wind power, Germany is doing much better in that. Almost twice as much they are delivering than the Netherlands and Belgium. So there's differences there, and that means also loss in potential. We don't use the potential for harvesting sustainable energy in this area very well. And of course, there's a huge untapped potential underneath the ground still in terms of geothermal qualities that could be harvested. But we should do this together. It needs a network and approach on the Eurodelta scale. Last point, people commuting, basically using the area as if there is no borders. This is an inventorization of people working on the other side of the border in orange. People based in the Netherlands working in Germany and Belgium. Yellow for the Belgium people working in the Netherlands and Germany, and red for the people living in Germany and working in Belgium and the Netherlands. So there is some commute over this border. It's starting to become more and more one area, and particularly this is interesting, of course, for highly educated, well-educated people. And also there is the infrastructure is there. University centers are very well connected between each other, and there is literally starting to appear this kind of university-based knowledge-based network. But we lack in terms of providing also connections directly in the close vicinity of the border. It was raised already a couple of times. We have to make sure that we don't leave behind part of the country. So I think that's an important thing to come forward. My last point, so this is quite an agenda, and it's quite a lot of challenges, and you could feel that it's overwhelming and impossible to do something about it. But I think it's important to come up with ideas and to present them in such a way that they gain some certain traction. And I just have one example of which I'm very much inspired. An example done in the context of the International Architectural Biennial, showing in a huge animation the potential of the North Sea. It was also already mentioned in one of the lectures in terms of its potential for sustainable energy production. This was made visible in such an appealing way that first it was shown in an exhibition, but very quickly after it was shown to the European ministers of economic development, and that presentation led to the conclusion in the Netherlands that finally we need to do something, we need to change course, and now very rapidly we're using this potential in the North Sea. So this idea to real execution has taken a very, very limited time span. I think it's very important for all of you to know that this is possible, and you should focus on trying to do that. Because a quote from this International Architecture Biennial, the future is already here. It's just not evenly distributed. So please, let's have this podium to more evenly distribute these ideas. Thank you very much.